And we're back.
Initialize. It wasn't built to be this fucking big, so it's the the attractive force.
Hello and welcome to the Game Dev Outpost. In this video, we're going to talk about the basics of Niagara Ribbons in Unreal 4. So, before we talk about the ribbons, I actually want to show you some things that I've imported. In my textures folder, I've imported two textures. One with non-stretched numbers, and the second one with stretched numbers. And then, in my materials folder, I have a master material and two material instances. Those material instances have those textures on them. In the master material, I have a texture node and a particle color, and these are all being multiplied into the base color, the emissive color, and the opacity. So, let's take a look at the effect. I'm going to start by creating an emitter from the blank template. So I'll go to effects, Niagara emitter, empty, and give it a good name, NE, Ribby, Now, rhythm emitters are a lot like particle emitters, but we need different modules that we use to remove particles. So, we're going to get rid of initialize particle, in particles folder, and we're going to get rid of the sprite render in the render. Now, in render, if we click on this plus icon, you should see rhythm render. Now, if we click on the rhythm render, you'll see that there's a bunch of options in here, and it's very similar to the particle render, but we want to add a material. For me, I'm going to add one of those material instances that I just made. So I'll add the non-stretch one, use that, and next, we need to come back up to particle spawn. So we're going to click on the plus icon, and if you search for a ribbon, you'll find initialized ribbon. Now we're still not rendering anything, we still can't see anything, and in this case, it's because we're not spawning anything. So in emitter update, we need to come I'm going to add spawn rate, and for now, I'm going to add something like 10. And yet, once again, you'll notice nothing is rendering, nothing's showing. And that's because ribbons are based on movement. We need some sort of movement to make them actually render. So, for debugging, in particle update, I'm going to add velocity, just so we can see something in the preview. And you may get this fixed issue, chances are you're missing this solid forces and velocity. Then it'll add that module. It should work out. Now, whichever axis you want, you can put whatever number you want. I'm going to put 10 on the Y. And I'm going to search for it and zoom in here. And right away, you can see that this ribbon is already rendered. I do have a pause, so I'll just show you what it looks like when we play. See it shoot out, and it gets really long. You see that it's jittering. It is jittering really fast. So let's look at initialized ribbon first. And it's really interesting. The two main things we want to look at in here are the lifetime and the ribbon width. So the ribbon width, this is really the height. This is the height of the ribbon. Right? So if we increase this, you'll see where this is paused right now. These numbers aren't stretched anymore. They look a little closer to normal. Now, if we let this play out a little bit longer so we can see how far this stretches, pause it. If we look at the lifetime, you look at the lifetime almost as the length. Right? How long do you want this ribbon to be? How far do you want it to stretch? So if we reduce the lifetime, you see that this starts to shrink. You get compressed. Or if we expand it, it stretches even further. And then we just make it taller. Now there's another thing going on. So you see if we let this play, it gets all jittery. And that's because of the spawn rate. If you look right now, we have 10. We set this to 1. You'll see that it just snaps. Right? It snaps and fades. And if we bump it up to 5, you see it starts to get a little more jittery because they're starting to overlay each other. Bump this up to 20. Still a little jittery. Let's bump it up to 50. You can see it looks like it stops. It's a little smoother now. So from here, we're going to delete the add velocity, and we're going to save this. The next thing we want to do is create a Niagara system. Close this, and in our concept browser, we'll right-click, create Niagara system. Let's name it correctly. Call it NS. And let's drag it out here. And when we move this around, you should see that this is working right away. But you can see that this is really long. And in a way, the length of if we move this line faster, it's going to get a lot longer. And we can change this even more. We come back to our lifetime. We open up our emitter, come back to our initialized ribbon. We reduce this to something like 0.25. Say, come back here. You can see that this is a lot shorter. Now, another thing to note here is, you can see as we pull this, see how much of the texture is actually taking up those ribbon cards? It's not really a lot. And because of that, whenever we start to do curves like this, right, those cards end up bunching up and we get artifacts from that. So if you can, you want to use better texture space with these ribbons to reduce the amount of artifact, the chance that you can have artifact. So, in my Niagara emitter, I'm going to go back to my ribbon renderer, and I'm going to use the stretch grid. So it's a little bit taller, not necessarily taking up the whole texture, but it takes up a lot more space. Let's save, and let's go take a look at what that looks like. And you can see, in this case, it's taking up that space a lot better. Alright guys, this covers the basics of Niagara ribbons. If you thought this video was useful and it helped, please let me know by commenting down below and liking the video. Thanks guys.
to the unnamed particle tutorial series thing. Today we're going to be looking at applying forces over time, which you might be thinking, hey, didn't we like learn about applying forces and shit in the last video? Well, you are wrong. Here's why. A particle system has two kind of stages. Here's our test emitter from last time. Basically, there's the particle spawn, where we apply initial forces. So this is just applying a force at the very start. What we're going to be doing in this video is exploring all of the ways we can apply forces during the particle's lifetime. So for example, we can use a drag force to make the particles slow down as they, you know, as they progress through their lifetime. So if we put the drag up to like 5 or something, you can see that these particles shoot out, but then they stop after a while. Drag is probably one of the most important things to be adding to your particles, because otherwise they kind of just go everywhere and you've got no control over them. 90% of particles that you're going to be creating will have drag on them. Another really handy force is curl noise force. So you can see that these particles don't have any force applied at the start of their lifetime. This does look very pretty, yes, very simple, very pretty. But if we add some curl noise force, you can see that it's kind of just this random little air streams is probably a good way to look at it. So if we put the, you know, the strength up to like very high, you can adjust the frequency of it. So the lower the frequency, the bigger the overall kind of noise pattern is. It's a three-dimensional noise. So this is just a really good way to add some variation and randomness to all your particles. And honestly, just it by itself looks very nice. Now, one thing that I always like to do is actually put the noise quality at low all the time, just because it is the cheapest and I really can't notice the difference between the low quality and the high quality one. The low quality noise is perfectly fine because I'm just looking for that little bit of randomness. So what I'm going to show you now is another way that the initial velocity is different to the forces over time. So you can see here we've got this particle thing, it's doing like an explosion and then they're all just stopping. I've got some drag applied. So let's get this velocity and make it between 100 and 1000. But if we do a particle update, we'll do a point attractor force. So all of these particles are going to get kind of sucked back in. We're going to do the attraction radius to like very big, and the attraction strength we'll do to 10. So you can see now they're all getting
we crank it up.